Right. Good evening, or good afternoon, good morning, wherever you're watching. There's not many people watching right now, but maybe you will come later. So I will continue now the drawing I started yesterday. Laid down the foundations. It's very blurry yet, not very detailed. So yeah, let's just get going. So first of all, I'm gonna wipe it clean with this brush. It'll make it more, more blended even. So yeah, I had the chance to look at it from another perspective, so I noticed some things. The eyes seem to be a little bit off. She's looking more up than it should be. So I would like to correct that. It should be more lower the eyelashes. Hi Jonathan. Thank you for joining. Hope you enjoyed yesterday's stream. I was just telling I had the chance to look at it from a different perspective, and I noticed something wrong about the eyes. So that's what I'm going to correct now. Hopefully. So yeah, yesterday I told you the eyes are the most important features. So they should be okay. So that's why I'm spending extra time on it. And it's good to do it in an early stage rather than at the end if you want to correct it. Right at the end, if you have laid down all the details, it's not that easy, obviously. And also, when you have the eyes, you're gonna have the feeling of if it's correct or not. If you're on the right track, so to speak. I'm constantly checking, so it's 50% of my time I'm looking at the drawing and 50% I'm looking at the reference. Thank you, Jonathan. Working on the eyes now. Oh, is my wife coming in?
Niet op de camera.
Want rustig.
Heb je morgen
ochtend? Morgenochtend?
Ja, want ik ga om kwart voor acht met de kinderen.
Ja, dat is goed. I'm sorry, that was my wife just talking to her. So, yes, I'm looking at the space between the corner of the eye and the iris, and right now it seems a little bit long, but that's, I think, because, well, this is actually the width of the eye, and this is the eyelid here. So if you look closely, you'll see that this distance is even a bit further. Oh, by the way, I wrote down in the description of this stream the YouTube channel of the artist that made the painting that I'm drawing from. If you don't know him, I think he's a great artist, and he has a great YouTube channel. So definitely worth to take a look there. It's called Cesar Santos. And by the way, I'm still trying not to draw an eye per se, but trying to draw shapes instead of an eye. And if you keep doing that, it will look like an eye all on its own, if you're doing it okay. I'm looking at the reference right now and looking back and forth. Usually if you flip up and down from the reference to your drawing, then the differences will become clear. Again, I'm trying to draw the shadow shapes here. We try to look at the shadow shapes as an abstract form. The portrait art and Zen Lim. Yeah, Zen Lim is a great artist, really. And portrait artist, of course. That's the reason I started, actually. That was about 1.5 years ago, when I discovered his channel, The Portrait Art. And I joined his Patreon. And yeah, we started drawing together a few months ago. We stream together now. The Shady and Sketchy Show. But it's very nice that you started drawing again. Did you draw it before? Or is this first time? I would like to know. Because for me it was drawing again. I drew a long time ago. I drew a lot, but yeah, then I lost interest for some reason. First time drawing, yeah, that can be difficult. But if you haven't drawn before, I would just recommend getting to know the materials and just make a lot of just sketches. Don't try to make a masterpiece. Because yeah, you'll have to get used to the materials. Just feel like if you're drawing in charcoal, just yeah, draw stick figures or a circle, or and then try different things like going over it with your finger or with a brush or even with a chamois. I have a chamois here, and you can see what effect it has on it. That's what I would advise in the beginning. But it's very nice to hear that actually people are inspired to draw because of partly because of me. And you know, I'm actually a little bit honored to be compared to Zin Lim and portrait art. I hope you're having fun with drawing. That's the most important thing. If you're not having fun, you start losing interest, and then you stop doing it. That would be a shame. So first and foremost, just have fun with the things you do. You actually start with hyperrealism, since that's what YouTube recommends more. Really? Hyperrealism. Yeah. I know that a lot of people are attracted to it, hyperrealism, but I'm not a great fan of it. It's looks very impressive, I'm sure. And you see a lot of it, and a lot of those drawings are made using a grid, and then it looks very realistic, but it just trains different things. It doesn't train you to be an like, if you want to draw from life, you can't use the grid. Yeah, maybe there are people actually drawing with the standard methods and make it hyper-realistic. Maybe they can. But the drawback would be, maybe, if you can even consider it a drawback, that you can make mistakes, and there's gonna be drawings that just fail. That's part of it. Actually, I have one on my channel. I call it the failed attempt at drawing Barbara Palin. I really think that wasn't such a successful drawing, but it's all part of the process, really. Right, so at the bottom of the bottom lip, there's usually this shadow shape. I'm trying to replicate. Practicing anatomy and some basics. Nice. Anatomy is a great way to start. If you know the anatomy, you can construct things that wouldn't be clear in a photograph. So that's great. Very good. Right now I'm trying to be very direct with the lines and not have too many short strokes, because that will show, and it will look like like this, you know, and that doesn't look good. So even though I can blend it, but I sometimes leave the lines around the face like less blended and concentrate more on the features. Wow, that looks a little bit wide. Okay, I think the jawline needs to come up more, like this. Derwent. Yeah, I have different ones. At first I didn't really like them because they're very hard. Even the dark ones, they are very hard. So I started out using these, the generals. But here in the Netherlands, they don't sell them. So I have a batch, and I recently got another batch of them. So I'm very happy with that. But they are much softer, so it's great for shading. But I generally use the Derwents for the details, and they can get very dark, so that's nice as well. So for the eyes, it would be these that I use in Mexico. Yeah, Amazon. Amazon doesn't really ship to the Netherlands. They do some, but not all of it. Not all of the things you can get in the States. Okay, now I'm more into drawing the contours. And later on I can come back to the face. It's good to sometimes deviate from the things that you're concentrating on for a long time. Then you can lose perspective, so I'm going back to it in a minute, but so right now I'm looking for the ears, the earlobe, and they should be at the same level. If you go across the face, you can always check with other nearby parts of the face. So maybe, yeah, this should be higher, right? It should be higher. Hey, Black Flame. People say you gotta study the anatomy down to the bone. Yeah, that's a very good thing. Especially the bones. It's funny that you mentioned the bones, because the bony structure, you can see it here. This is the zygomatic arc, they call it, I think. So it's a bone that runs from here to there. This is part of the orbital, the eye socket. So, and this is actually a ridge. I think it's called the temporal ridge. So yeah, it's very good to know your anatomy. Famous artists from back then actually looked at the corpus. Yeah, they did. I actually watched a TV show the other day, not long ago, from Leonardo da Vinci. And he spent 5 years of his time just cutting up dead bodies because he wanted to know what it looked like. And in that time, it wasn't done yet, so. Oh, but cartoony stuff can be good. Yeah, if you can draw cartoons, of course it's a different technique, but if you can draw accurately, you can also draw realistically. Yeah, the anatomy, it's, well, sometimes you gotta have a good stomach for it, but if you're not doing it in real life, it's supposed to be okay, I think. Yeah, you know, if you know your anatomy, you're going to look at things differently. And actually, if you start drawing more, you're gonna look at things differently. You're always checking, like, how would I draw that? If you're watching at someone in real life, then you would always think, wow, how would I draw that? And now that I look at the reference, I see that the proportions are not really okay. It's that I think the head is longer than it should be. Let me check. So this, if I check this, that's about okay, I think. Yeah. Okay, the mouth is too low. That's it's okay, you can correct it. So let me see, I think this, the corner of the mouth should be more like here, I think. Yeah, so it was a good 3 millimeters too low, I think. And of course I related the bottom of the chin to the mouth, so that was, then it makes the whole head too high, too tall. it can be frustrating sometimes. But it just comes down to recognizing your mistakes and knowing how to fix them. So that means that the shadow shape underneath the lips should move up as well. Yeah, it's part of learning. I know that's why it's important to just sometimes step back and look at it, and of course I have the benefit, I see my stream at the same time, so I can directly see the reference next to my my drawing, just as you're seeing on the stream. So yeah, that helps, but if you don't have that, you can always just have a print your reference and have it next to it, or yeah, step back, just step a few steps back and then look at it from a distance. So yeah, now you can see, because I was having trouble with the angle of this jaw line, it went too much straight down, and that's when I thought, hey, this chin is too low, and then I started watching at the height of the mouth. That's how I noticed. What do you guys think? Is this okay now? The proportions. Hope so. I think this Irish could be a little bit more to the inside. I might have drawn it a little bit too far out. It makes it bigger, of course, but maybe this one should be bigger as well. Not sure. Yeah, I think yeah, is that an improvement? I think it is. But just leave it. So I think it's time to add some value in the other parts, and this is gonna scratch. I hope you can hear my voice over it. This will probably make a very loud noise, but hope it's not too bad. Take something else. So right now I'm just laying down some foundation for the skin tone, because I want it to I want the face to come up more, and that's how you make it do it. Just darken the values of the surroundings. Your hands get very dirty. that's part of the fun. Right now with my dirty fingers I saw the opportunity to darken the values on the shadow side of the face. Because a hat is a round thing, right? So as it turns away from the light, it will become darker, obviously. Yeah, right now the hair doesn't look very structured, but that's just because it's one big black blob, sort of. So I'll try to make some structure into it, then it will look better then. Okay. I think the music stopped, so let's see. There it is again. That's one thing I like about charcoal. You can get so solid with the colors. You can get so black and so solid. It's something that would take you ages with graphite pencils. Got very dusty. Okay, I think it's time for the final refinement layer. So I hope you noticed that I work pretty much in layers. First you think, well, this is done, but then I smudge it all again and do it all over again. But that's part of the process. And each time I do it, the features become more and more detailed and more realistic. And this line here, the eyelid, this fold, it's pretty dark, but it shouldn't be black. It should be completely black. So should try to avoid having too much contrast there.
Wait.
With the eyelashes you can go pretty dark, especially because most women have makeup, and clearly this reference does, or she's just dark in complexion, dark hair, but you can accentuate it, it doesn't matter. It actually makes it more appealing if you do it. But don't overdo it, I would say. Do you guys have that you're always looking for stuff, you always lose your things? I will always looking for my eraser or my specific kind of pencil or my brush. I always have that. And once I put in the highlights in the eye, it's gonna pop and become all of a sudden realistic. It's always the fun thing to do, but it's always the thing you should do at the very end, because you can lose it very easily, especially with charcoal, because of all the charcoal dust moving around. Can easily get in the place of the highlight, and then you'll have to do it again and again and again. Even though it's fun, it's really fun to do it, so sometimes you do it right away. What do you think? And do the highlight. I think I'm gonna do the highlight. Right. noticed the other side, there's a very small highlight. And it's these kinds of things that, if you notice them, that make it realistic. But of course, this is a painting, so it has been noticed before by the artist who drew this. And maybe accentuated it even a little bit. I think this is always the fun stage of the drawing, where you can grab your needed eraser and pull out the light. Very gently. Yeah, in the ridge of the nose, there's always a highlight. Tip of the nose, of course. Time for the other eye, I think. This eye. Always looking for stuff. Oh, maybe this one was work. And pencils falling on the ground. You guys have that? I have it all the time. Something not right about this. sorry if I don't speak over the whole video. Sometimes it gets silence, but yeah, I have to concentrate and just let you watch. If you have any questions, just ask them in the chat. We'll be sure to watch the chat, the comments. Otherwise, I will just keep on going, just keep on drawing. Maybe we'll even finish it. Or maybe I'm gonna finish it tomorrow. The eyes are very dark. It's almost complete black. Notice how the eyelashes, they cast a shadow over the white of the eye. And that's what I'm drawing in now. And then the shadow wraps around because of the sphere shape of the eye. Yeah, and it's also possible to blend with the pencil. I don't feel like stopping yet, but it's getting a little bit late, so maybe I'll continue for 10 minutes or so, maybe 15. This is so much fun. But you guys have that if you're doing something fun that you're enjoying, and then all of a sudden you just lost track of time. And you look at the clock and then it's like 3 a.m. or something. Yeah, I think the white of the eye on the I'm working on right now is too light. It should be that light. So I'm toning it down a little. That's better. Okay. Working on the cast shadow of the nose now. Notice the cast shadow is always a little bit darker than the object casting it. That's because the object is receiving more of the bounce light. So there's gonna be a reflected light here. Maybe that nostril could be a little bit higher. By the way, I'm using this blending stump and I'm wiping it clean on my chamois here. I've got a chamois. And, Okay. I think I'm almost done for now, for today. So, I'll probably continue tomorrow, and then I will we'll finish this drawing for sure. Well, I wasn't planning on doing a three sessions for this, but yeah, it is what it is. And yeah, if you like this, if you like the slow process, it's definitely slow, then well, then you're at the right place. So, right, before I continue on the mouth, let's just leave it at this. I think tomorrow I will continue at around the same time. And I know this eyebrow is not correct, but okay, let's do it tomorrow. Yeah, thank you for watching. I think at least one person still here. Thank you for sticking to the end. And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.